Today we're thinking about being good neighbours.
Oh, and here's your coffee back. Thanks very much.
Oh, that's all right. Oh, that reminds me. There's that.
Oh, thanks.
There's that.
Well, hello everyone, and welcome to the final episode of CAMSA Connect before the summer break.
It's great to have you along today. Today, we're in Luke chapter 10 to revisit the familiar parable of the Good Samaritan, and we're thinking about what it means to be a good neighbour.
Coming up in today's episode, we have music from our band, who look like they're at the seaside. Ginnie chooses her favourite song, and some of the fellas of the CAMSA family bring a new take on the Good Samaritan story. Although I do think Paul looks like he's been in the wars.
Yeah, that could be part of the story. Let's see. But let's commence our worship with a song which celebrates God's guidance and protection in our lives. Please join us in singing, "Thy Hand, O God, Has Guided."
Thanks for that good sing. We'll say a short prayer now, so please feel free to read the words with us as they appear on the screen. Father God, we thank you for this time of worship today. Thank you that you call us to love you and love others.
As we think about what it means to be a good neighbour, may we be alert to the needs of the people around us and open to your leading in how best to help them. In Jesus' name, Amen.
And Amen. Okay, well, coming up, we've got the online offering. You'll need your smartphone for that and some music from our senior band. They're going to be playing a march called Bognor Regis, which is the name of a seaside town on the south coast of England.
That's right. And the march was actually written to celebrate an annual Salvation Army holiday week held at the Butlin Centre in Bognor. So it features the theme song from that event, Life is a Song. So look out for some aerial views of Bognor and some footage of one of the holiday weeks from the 1980s.
Excellent. First, though, we'd like to introduce you to one of the newer members of our congregation. Here with a word about her favourite song is Ginnie.
Hello everyone, I'm Virginia Sauter, Ginnie to my friends. The song I've chosen is He Who Would Valiant Be by John Bunyan. I was born and christened in 1957 and confirmed in the High Church at St Edward's, Romford, near London, in 1971. At that time, I was a regular member of St Thomas's Church, Noak Hill, again near London, in 1970s, where I became their Sunday school teacher until I left to attend further education at Bath Academy and Brighton Art College. My godparents gave me a book, Pilgrim's Progress by John Bunyan, and this is where I first read He Who Would Valiant Be. When I hear it, it takes me back to when I first gave my heart to God. This book and its song have had a huge influence on me.
To make a better day. Neighbors need to get to know each other. Next door is only a footstep away. Neighbors, everybody needs good neighbors. Perfect blend. Neighbors should be there for one another. That's when good neighbors become. Thank you.
Thanks to the band for that energetic march, and thank you to Ginnie for introducing He Who Would Valiant Be. It takes courage to be a good neighbour sometimes.
It sure does. And thanks for your support too in the online offering. It's very much appreciated and it helps us in Cambridge here make a difference in the lives of others.
And as always, there are other ways to support listed in the description below. Now, you may have noticed that Norman is away on holiday today. But he's left us a list of things to tell you about. What are they?
Let's have a look at the list. Well, he says that we need to remind everyone about the prayer leaflets, okay? The dates for the final farewell meeting at the barracks, the first Sunday back in the new hall, and the official opening too. And I think that's about it.
But there's all that black writing at the bottom in bold. What's that? Oh, in capitals?
Yeah, he must really want us to say that. Okay, he says, please don't ruin things for my fans by telling a joke. It's a bit harsh, isn't it?
It is.
I might be away, but I still control things around here. Well, that's what he thinks. Here's a joke for you, everybody. Why did the good neighbour cross the road? Excellent.
That's an excellent joke, and I'm sure people enjoyed that. And there's nothing Norman can do to stop us. So there.
That's right. I think that just might be the best joke we've ever told.
Absolutely.
On CAMSA Connect. Anyway, where were we? Oh, yes. As we start thinking about the story of the Good Samaritan that Jesus told, we're going to be singing the song When I Needed a Neighbour and watching a new sketch by some of the guys here at CAMSA.
Yes. And in this version of the Good Samaritan, the characters are only allowed to say one word at a time. It'd be interesting to see how they manage to do that.
Yeah, it could be quite difficult for some of them.
Yes. First up, though, let's hear the actual account. And here to read it for us today is one of our young people, Baracha.
The Parable of the Good Samaritan. Luke 10, verses 25 to 37. On one occasion, an expert in the law stood up to confront Jesus. Teacher, he asked, what must I do to inherit eternal life? What is written in the law? He replied. How do you read it? He answered, love the Lord your God with all your heart, and all your soul, and all your strength, and with all your mind, and love your neighbour as yourself. You have answered correctly, Jesus replied. Do this and you will live. But he wanted to justify himself, so he asked Jesus, and who is my neighbour? In reply, Jesus said, a man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho when he was attacked by robbers. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him and went away, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the same road, and when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. So too a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he travelled, came where the man was, and when he saw him, he took pity on him. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, pouring on oil and wine. Then he put the man on his own donkey, brought him to an inn and took care of him. The next day he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper. "Look after him," he said, "and when I return, I'll reimburse for any extra expense he may have." Which of these three do you think was a neighbour to the man who fell into the hands of robbers? The expert in the world, the one who had mercy on him. Jesus told him, "Go and do likewise."
Hi.
Ow.
Oh.
Ah. Ow.
Ah. Oh. Oh.
Ah.
Hmm.
Huh?
There.
Ah! Oh. Shh. Huh?
Come.
Hello.
Accommodation?
Sure.
En suite?
No.
Pool?
No.
CAMSA Connect?
Always.
Thanks.
Bonjour.
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 God bless you.
That's three words.
So is that.
So is that.
So today we're looking at one of Jesus' best known stories, the parable of the Good Samaritan. Even if you don't know the story, you probably have an idea that it's about helping people. If you lend someone a hand, you might be described as a Good Samaritan, and you may know about the organisation called the Samaritans here in the UK and in Ireland, whose volunteers provide a listening service for people in crisis. But for Jesus' Jewish audience 2,000 years ago, this story was a real shock. The Jews and the Samaritans absolutely hated one another in those days, so the thought of a Good Samaritan, well, for them, it was a contradiction in terms. It would be like us today hearing a story about a good racist or a good terrorist, a real contradiction. So what happens in this story then? Well, the events take place on the road from Jerusalem to Jericho. Now, this is a road that's about 18 miles long, and it goes from 1,200 feet above sea level at Jerusalem to 2,200 feet below sea level at Jericho. So it goes down 188 feet, or a 13-story building, every single mile. Now, according to scholar John Wilkinson, the road was known as the Way of Blood because of the blood which is often shed there by robbers. So the road is a physically difficult path to negotiate. But another issue was that travellers heading to and from Jerusalem often had money with them, of course. And so thieves knew this, and they would lie in wait by the side of the road. Muggers had plenty of places to hide in amongst the rocks and plenty of stones with which to attack unsuspecting travellers. So when Jesus announced that his story was about a man travelling from Jerusalem to Jericho, his listeners precisely knew the road that he was talking about. And sure enough, the man in Jesus' story was attacked. He was beaten up, robbed, and left for dead. And that's how our story begins, with a body on the road. But it ends with a body that's given a second chance, thanks to a display of human kindness by one of the man's cultural enemies. Well, as we all hopefully know, Jesus used this story, this parable, to illustrate one of the most important commandments, that we're to love our neighbour as we love ourselves. At the end of the story, he asked his audience, "Which of these three do you think was a neighbour to the man who fell into the hands of the robbers?" And the answer, of course, is the one who took pity on him, the Samaritan. This story shows that to love your neighbour, you don't have to agree with him or even like him. What matters is that you help your neighbour, whoever he or she is. Well, who are our neighbours today, you might ask? Are they our actual neighbours, the people that live next door to us? Or are they our friends or our family? What about the people in other countries overseas? Your work colleagues, your gym friends? And how about the homeless lady that sits in the shop doorway in your high street? Well, the answer, I guess, is all these people are our neighbours. Some of these people we don't know at all. Some are hard to like, and some don't like us. But they are all our neighbours. Today's story reminds us that our feelings about people are irrelevant when it comes to lending a hand. Loving our neighbours means doing whatever we can to help them. So today, may God help you and me to do just that.
They need
Please join with us in prayer. Lord God, we thank you for the parable of the Good Samaritan, which challenges us all to love everyone, regardless of who they are or what their background is. You love every person in the world and call us to do likewise.
So teach us, Lord, to be Good Samaritans too. Send us out in your name to love our neighbours and point them toward you and your love for them. In your name we pray. Amen.
And amen. Well, thanks for joining us this week. We hope you enjoyed this worship service. And if you did, please give it a thumbs up. It really helps the video show up in recommendation for others. And don't forget to leave us a hello in the comments below.
That's right. Now, don't forget we're taking a short break for the summer, but we look forward to returning to you on Sunday, the 11th of September, the date of our return to our new refurbished buildings. And when we return, there'll be lots to tell you about with all that's going on here. So we hope you can join us for season 4 of CAMSA Connect.
Wow, season 4 already.
Season 4.
Well, we must tell you that we are currently recruiting volunteers for our new facility. So look out for Team CAMSA posts here on YouTube and on Facebook in the coming weeks. We'd love for you to get involved in what we are doing. In fact, if you're interested in working with us, you can email us at the address on screen.
And also look out for some special music and testimony videos over the summer too. CAMSA Connect might be on break, but there'll be plenty for you to see here online. So don't forget to link with us on Facebook and click subscribe and the bell icon here on YouTube to be notified whenever we upload some new content.
So thanks once again to the awesome Cambridge Salvation Army folks for helping us with CAMSA Connect over the past year. It is really appreciated.
And to you all, have a great summer. Keep safe, keep well.
And keep connected. God bless you.